Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Japan Hubba 2021 Mizuhiki Workshop. Before we begin today, let us take a look at what Mizuhiki is and our instructor for today.
Hi, I'm Matt Alt, and this is Plus One. If you've spent any amount of time in Japan, you've seen these envelopes that are used for gifting money. They're special envelopes for weddings, special envelopes for births, special envelopes for getting into school, and special envelopes for funerals. These are all used to give money in special situations. Why do Japanese go to all of this effort to package the money they give? That's what we're going to find out on today's episode.
Most stationery shops have a large selection of envelopes used especially for gifting money. These traditional packages are made from washi paper and decoratively tied with thin paper cord. The cord tells you that the envelope has not been opened and reflects sincerity. For a happy occasion, auspicious colors are used, gold and silver or red and white. The knot is symbolic too. To convey the hope that a birth or academic success will be repeated, an easily repeatable bow is used. For an auspicious occasion, it's considered good practice to use brand new unfolded notes. A funeral marks an event that cannot be undone. Pulling on the loose ends will only tighten this knot. Occasions, it is important to show that the money has been used. The idea is that because the bad news was sudden, there was no time for sufficient preparation. Depending on the context of use, people pay careful attention to the color and shape of the cords and to other details. This time, Matt will meet Kyoko Mitsumata, a designer of paper cord decorations.
They tell me that you're an expert about...
Besides manufacturing the cord, Mitsumata runs a workshop that explores the deeper significance of giving gifts.
Oh! There are the envelopes. This seems to be an animal of some kind. What is this? Is this a bird?
Yes, it's actually a crane. In Japan, a crane is seen as a divine messenger, bringing happiness and good fortune down from the heavens. That's what a crane represents. This design is used at weddings and on other auspicious occasions. You can bend it like this, as a finishing touch.
It's very pretty.
The custom of giving money in elaborate envelopes is well established in Japan. What values does it reflect?
Well, for auspicious events and on other milestone occasions, people want to express their feelings. Simply handing over cash is pretty crude. They want to show that they have gone to some trouble. I see that as part of the cultural context.
Matt's going to try recreating this design. It represents Mount Fuji, another auspicious motif.
So what do we do first?
The cords are strands of twisted paper. By stretching out the paper, we can make it more flexible.
Five strands is an appropriate choice for an auspicious shape.
Hold them in the middle and pull the ends up with your other hand. Bend them round the back to form a loop. Hold them with your left hand, hold the looped cord with your right hand, then let go with your left. Now thread through this loop. Then through the middle.
If this were surgery, I think my patient would be dead. Okay, and how long does it take
to get good at this.
I suppose it's just practice. The more you do it, the better you get.
This looks more like a jellyfish than it does like Fuji-san.
It's fine.
I'm always told that.
You've done very well.
Yeah. No, it's because of you. It's because I have a good teacher. And believe me, when we look at these side by side, you're going to be able to tell the difference.
The next step is to attach Matt's handiwork to an envelope. No gift envelope is complete without a banknote. And they're ready.
Wow, impressive. Thank you very much for showing me how to do this. You know, in the West, the giving of money as a gift is sometimes seen as almost vulgar, like you didn't put a lot of thought into the present. But when you wrap your money in a beautiful envelope like this, it's a completely different story, isn't it? And it just goes to show you how important the Japanese see packaging, even when giving gifts of money.
皆さん、こんにちは。
Hello, everyone.
Japan Habba 2021へようこそ。
Welcome to Japan Habba 2021.
私たち Japan Habba 実行委員は、本物の芸術に触れることを通して、本当の日本の姿を知っていただくきっかけになると信じており、毎年本物の日本文化をご紹介し、またアーティストの方をご招待しています。
Every year at Japan Habba, we introduce authentic Japanese culture by inviting artists from Japan. The opportunity to experience the true picture of Japan will refine your knowledge and leave you with memories that last a lifetime. We hope to bring this opportunity to you at Japan Habba.
今年は Japan Bridge チームのメンバーが水引きを皆さんにご紹介します。
Today, we would like to introduce Mizuhiki.
美しい伝統芸能の一つである水引きを教えてくださるアーティストの先生をご紹介します。
I will introduce the Mizuhiki artist who will teach us how to make them and we will make it along with her together. Let's get creative while also learning the Japanese culture.
今日は皆さんで一緒に実際に作ってみましょう。コンテストもありますよ。上手にできた人には商品もあります。ぜひ最後までお付き合いください。
We also have an exciting contest. So whoever makes the most beautiful Mizuhiki creation stand a chance to win exciting prizes. So stick with us until the very end.
本日の講師の先生は三又京子さんです。では、江刺さん、ご紹介お願いします。
So the teacher for today is Ms. Kyoko Mitsumata. She is from Tokyo, where she lives with her husband, son, daughter, and cat. She not only creates, but also writes about Mizuhiki art. She loves cute and colorful things, and of course animals too. She studied design at an art university and went on to working on designing displays and spaces for hotels in Tokyo. While doing this, she learned the art of Mizuhiki and became an accomplished artist.Now, with 27 years of experience under her belt, she conducts Mizuhiki classes and workshops. She also does collaborations of illustrations as well with Mizuhiki. She incorporates Mizuhiki designs and costumes for stage productions and even makes accessories out of them. Her work has been showcased in both solo and group exhibitions. Yeah, over to you.
Greetings, Mizuhiki participants. The Japan Habba is now organizing a new surprise contest. the new Mizuhiki contest. To enter, take a picture of the Mizuhiki knot you learned and created today and do the following. Step 1. Upload it on your Facebook or Instagram account with the following hashtag. Hashtag JapanHabbaMizuhiki. Second step. Send the post to the Japan Habba Instagram account or the Japan Habba Bangalore or Facebook. The two winners will be selected by Matsumoto Sensei and will receive an Amazon gift voucher of 2,500 rupees each. May the best creation win. Thank you.
Over to Mitsumata Sensei. Mitsumata Sensei, onegai shimasu.
Konnichiwa, Mitsumata Kyoko desu. Kyou wa Indo no minasan to Nihon no dento bunka de aru Mizuhiki wo go issho dekiru koto totemo ureshiku omotte orimasu. Douzo yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Hello everybody, I'm Kyoko Mitsumata. And today, I am very happy to be able to share this Japanese traditions with you all. So let's all do our best.
では、Mizuhiki の説明から始めたいと思います。
So I would like to now explain about Mizuhiki to you all.
こちら。ごめんなさいね。画面を手元でお願いします。
Can you switch the camera to her hand?
こちらですね。こちらが、日本のお祝いをするときにお金を入れる封筒ですね。祝儀袋と言います。
So, this is a 祝儀袋 where they put in cash and it's used traditionally in the Japanese culture.
お祝いによって種類はいろいろとあるのですが、これまた後で説明していきますね。
So there are different types of these envelopes depending on the different kinds of ceremonies that take place, and I'll explain that a little later.
で、こちらが Mizuhiki です。
This is the Mizuhiki.
で、Mizuhiki のこの中に入っているものは、もっといという紙の紐。
So, what is used in these strands is known as mottai no himo, which is basically this band which was used to tie the hair.
その紙の紐に紙を巻いたり、キラキラした紙を巻いたり、糸を巻いたりして色をつけています。
So, in this band, they have these different kinds of colored paper.Which is used to be stuck together.
このようにセンターで色の違うもの、あとはこういったカラフルな水引きがたくさん種類、水引きもたくさんの種類があります。
So, like this, there are different kinds of colors that you can see in the center over there. And you have different kinds of varieties of these strands in different colors.
Fukuro ni mizuhiki o kakeru imi wa kamisama to kono yo, watashi tachi no iru tokoro wo mizuhiki.その境界線に水引きをかけて、神様からの恵みがありますようにという意味が込められています。
So the reason why we tie these mizuhiki around the envelopes is because it represents the connection between the world of gods and our world. So basically, through this mizuhiki, we are hoping to receive the blessings of God.
で、こちらの袋、お金が入っていくんですが、日本人はお金というのはいろんな人の手に渡るものなので、一度和紙に包んで清めます。
So, they usually put money in this envelope. And because, you know, money goes on from one person to another, so this is basically done to kind of purify the money.
こちらの水引きのセンターで分かれた色。
So this is the 水引き where it's divided in the center.
銀が神様の色。金が私たちの世界の色。
So silver represents the color of the gods and gold represents our world.
同じように白が神様の色、赤が私たちの色。
So in the same way, white represents the gods, red represents us.
で、こちらの袋の折り方も白の神様の世界と赤の私たちの世界を水引きで境界線を作って神様の通り道にします。
So as you can see in this envelope, so the white represents the realm of the gods, the red represents our world, and so the mizuhiki is like the boundary that ties both worlds.
いろいろな mizuhiki の形、この形ですね、こういった形、お祝いによって形が変わります。
So you can see there are different styles of tying the mizuhiki here. So these styles of tying will depend on what kind of occasion that we are giving this envelope.
例えばこちら。この漢字を書くんですが、結婚式ですとか、一回きりのお祝いに使います。
So for example, this, you can see one kanji that was written there. So this kind of an envelope would be used for a wedding ceremony.
こちらは何度あっても嬉しいお祝いに使います。
So this envelope is used for any kind of happy occasion.
その他も、こちらのゴージャスなこれはフェニックス、鳳凰ですね。こちらは結納に使います。
So,
の結婚式の、新郎新婦のやりとりに使います。
So, this is, you can see it's a phoenix shaped mizuhiki, which is used again, which is a very beautiful, gorgeous kind of decoration.And this is used when you're handing over the money to the priest during the weddings.
あとは、ざっとデザインだけ、お祝いに使っていく。こちら、鶴ですね。鳥。日の出に、松に鶴です。
So, here you can see again, there are different types of mizuhiki, like, as an art form. And here, the one you see is a crane.
こちらは船、門出のお祝いなどに使います。あとは、新築祝い、お家を建てた時にのお祝いなんかに使います。
So, this mizuhiki is in the shape of a boat.And this is used when you're gifting someone when they've built a new house or during ikebana.
ね、これお家を建てた時に船を使うのは水の神様が家を火事から守ってくれるからです。
So the reason why we use the boat shape, especially when we are gifting someone when they've just built their house, is to show that you know the water god will protect them from any kind of fire accidents.
そんな感じでいろんな水引きの種類があります。
So in this way, there are different types of mizuhiki.
で、今日はこちらのアワビ結び。
So today we are going to be doing the basic knot, that's the アワビ結び。
こちら水引きの基本になっていますので、こちらを皆さんと一緒に作っていきたいと思います。
So, as mentioned earlier, this is the basic knot. So, we'd like to do this with you all.
で、こちらの水引き、お祝いに使った水引きは、捨てたりせず、次のお祝いに向けて使って、使い回していくことで、お祝いをたくさん重ねていきます。
So these kind of mizuhiki, as mentioned before, it's used for wonderful events. And you don't just throw it away after an event. You can keep using these to keep on gifting others. So, you know, you kind of build up the blessings as you keep passing it on to one another.
例えば、結婚した時にもらった祝儀袋を幸せな結婚生活を続けていけたら、こちらの水引き、誰かの結婚祝いの時に使いますが、離婚しちゃった場合は思い切って捨てます。
So, when you're gifting someone for their marriage, so to wish them, please live a very happy life for the rest of your life, you give this envelope. However, if in case there's a divorce, then please throw it out without holding back.
で水引き細工、水引きで形を作っていく上で、基本の結びがアワビ結びです。
So, as mentioned before, the basic knot in mizuhiki is the awabi knot.
この結びができると、いろいろな形が作れます。
If you're able to make this awabi musubi, you can make any kind of knot.
例えばこれ、着物を着た時の髪飾り、ヘアピンにつけて。
So for example, if you know the knot, you can even make something like this. That is the hairpin for the kimono.
こちらの土台。アワビ結びからできています。
This also has been made using the basic knot, that's the awabi musubi.
Mata. Koita accessory ni mo.
You can also use it for these kind of accessories.
こちらの輪っか。
And also for this decoration.
こちらもアワビ結びからできています。
This has also been made using the アワビ knot.
こちらのリボン、こちらもアワビ結びがたくさんついています。
So this cute ribbon is also made using the アワビ結び。
では、アワビ結び一緒に作っていきたいと思います。
So let's make the アワビ結び together. So take a 45 centimeter string.
まず2本から好きな色を2本選んでください。
So choose two strands of your liking.
ではやっていきたいと思います。
So let's begin.
まず、
道端すみません。はい、また質問があるみたいです。
はい。
ラニタさん、can you tell me the question?
はい、
はい、チャットでアナベルちゃんという人から質問があります。
はい、
この前に紹介されたちょっと複雑なデザインはできるようにどのぐらいかかりますか？ちょっと複雑なデザインとかできるようにどのぐらいかかりますか？
そうですね、人によるんですけど、まあ、2、3年頑張ってこうやればできるようになるんじゃないかなって。
2、3年？
うん、2、3年。
So it'll take about 2 or 3 years to be able to get really good at this.
で、今日、こちらのお花は作れますよ。
So today we're going to be making this beautiful flower.
大丈夫ですか?
Is it okay?
はい、よろしくお願いします。
はい、お願いします。
はい。では、あわび結び作っていきたいと思います。紐の先と先をだいたいこう揃えて、2本並べて揃えて、中心に指をかけます。
So, you hold the two ends of the two strands and you hold them together like she's showing you. And you put your finger in the middle and hold it.
中心を左手で持って。
So, you hold the middle with your left hand.
右手で左側に来てる水引きを内回りに丸めて、後ろに、この水引きの後ろに置きます。
So, using your right hand, bend the left side of the strands, on the inside, like how she's showing you.
置いたら、左手で、このクロスしたところを押さえます。
So, once you have done that,Hold the intersection or the cross with your left hand.
右手でこちらに長く余った水引きをこの輪っかの上にポンと置きます。
So then, take the long strands which are on the right side with your right hand and then place it above, as shown here.
その時にこの中心から遠くを持って置くのではなく、中心あたりを持ってポンと置いてあげてください。
So, don't take it, away for too, like, too far away. Keep it as close as possible to the middle.
で、ここの右手のクロスした部分を押さえます。
So here you will, hold the cross, which is from the, with the right hand.
上に来てる水引きを、上に来てる紐を下の紐の後ろにこの輪っかから出たこの辺を持ってスーッと下ろしてきてあげます。
So take the upper strand and, put it below the, down strand from the back.
で、このクロスを押さえます。
And then you'll hold this cross as well.
右手で下に来てる水引きを3つの穴、
So with your right hand, again, you'll take the strand. And here you can see these three holes here.
上から入って。
Take it from the top.
真ん中から出てきて。
Make it come out from the middle.
上から入ります。
And then again, go from the top.
これで、アワビ結びができました。
With this, you have made the アワビ結び。
アワビ結びがふっくらしてるうちに、ここ、水引きの紐の中心からきれいに並ぶように。
So adjust it from the middle.
水引きを整えていきます。
So keep pulling and adjusting to make it more beautiful. Till it becomes neat. So we are now going to make it slightly small. So first you take the upper part.
左右に開くように引いて。
So take the strands on both the left and right sides and then pull.
ここの輪が小さくなるのを。
So make sure that the ring in the middle becomes small.
小さくなったところ、このクロスを押さえます。
So once the ring has become small, then you will hold it there.
あとは左右の出てる紐を引っ張れば小さくなっていきます。
And then
繰り返します。
And then you keep pulling the strands on both the left and right sides till it becomes small.
これで綺麗なアワビ結びができました。で、もう一度、もう一個、二本で作っていきたいと思います。
So with this, you've made the awabi musubi. So now we'll take another two strands and make another.
まず、先と先をだいたい合わせて中心に指をかけます。
So first, again, hold both the ends.And then place your finger in the middle of these two strands.
中心を左手で持って紐が上向くように。
Hold the middle of the string with your left hand and ensure that the strands are facing upwards.
左にある水引きを内側に丸めていって、
Fold the left strand inwards.
後ろにクロス。
And
後ろに置きます。
And bring it backwards. Pull it backwards.
このクロスした部分を左手で押さえて、右手で中心あたりを持って、右の水引きを輪っかの上に置きます。
So hold the middle with your left hand and then bring the strands with your right hand towards almost the middle of the strand.
右手の近くにできたクロスを右手で押さえて。
So the strand which you brought with your right hand, hold it with your right hand.
左手を外して左手で上の水引きを下の水引きの後ろに下ろしてきます。
So then you release your left hand, take the upper strand and bring it below the down strand.
クロスした場所からこの三角形になった部分をしっかり押さえて。
So hold the middle bit where you can see it's come almost like a triangle.
下から出てる水引きで、ここにできた3つの穴、手前の穴から、
So take the long strand with your right hand, and then you can see these three holes that have come. So start with the first hole.
上から入って、真ん中から出てきて、上から入ります。
So you enter, you push the strand from the top, then pull it through the middle, and then take it out again through the top.
あとは、整えていきます。アイロンをかけるように水引きをきれいに並べて、上のクロスを引いて小さくする。
And then you adjust, the two strands and keep pulling it on both sides so that they become neat.
このようにバラバラに水引きがなってしまった場合は、内側の色から一本ずつ引っ張ります。
So in case your strands have gone a little off course, take each strand bit by bit and then pull each strand individually to adjust.
これで、このようにあわび結び、どんどん数を増やしていくと、
So in this way you have the awabi musubi. And if you have many of the awabi musubi,
これ15本です。
So this is made out of 15 strands.
一本ずつ増やして練習していきます。で、とりあえず、次は3本に挑戦したいと思います。
So like this, you keep increasing by one strand.So next we're going to try it with three strands.
3本で同じですね。作っていきます。
So we're going to do it in the same way with three strands.
先と先を合わせて、中心に指をかけて。
So once again, hold the ends of these three strands and then place your finger in the middle of the strands.
中心を3本並べて、しっかり左手で押さえます。
So hold all three strands properly with your left hand.
左の水引きを内側に丸めていって、
So with your left hand, bring the strand again in.Make it into a circle again with your left hand, with your right hand, and then pull it from the back.
左手で交差点、クロスした部分を押さえて。
Hold the hole with your left hand.
水引きの中心あたりを右手で持って、ポンと今できた輪っかの上に、
So again, using your left hand, you will hold the middle of the ring. And then with your right hand, take the long strands and then again put it over the ring.
右にできたクロスをしっかり右手で押さえて。
So the strand that you pulled using your right hand, hold it with the same hand.
上に来てる水引きを下の水引きの後ろに下ろしてきます。
And then you'll take the upper strand and pull it below the lower strand.
しっかり交差したところを押さえて。
Hold the intersection, properly.
下に来た水引きでこちら三つの穴ですね。そちらに入れていく、いきます。
So once again, take the long strand with your right hand and then you will put it through these three holes.
スーッと並べて持ってきたときに、3本だとこのように先がバラバラになっているので、手の空いてるとこでトントンと揃えて。
So when you have taken these three strands, there's a chance that the strands will, you know, not be aligned. So with your hand, try and align them.
手前の穴から上から入って真ん中から出てきて上から入る。
So again, starting with the last hole, you push it in and then pull it out from the middle hole and then again push it in through the last hole.
こちらバラバラになっているので内側の色から一本ずつ引っ張っていきます。
So since the strands again were not aligned, so we take each strand individually and pull them slowly.
形を整える。水引きを揃えていきます。
So like this, we adjust the shape of the mizuhiki.
今度は小さくしていきます。上にできたクロスを左右に持って、ぐーっと開くように。
So now we are going to align it. So pull from the left and right sides of the strand. Pull it slowly till you can kind of get a big hole on the ends.
しっかりこの上のクロスを持って
Take the cross on the top
左右の手を
And then on both your left and right sides, pull
一本ずつ引いてあげます
And pull each of them individually
こんな感じでアワビ結びが今3つできました。
So like this, you've made three awabi knots already.
何かここまででご質問来てますか
？Any questions up until now?
No, 大丈夫です。
はい。そうしましたら、ここから2つアレンジを作っていきたいと思います。
So now we're going to make two other arrangements with this.
まずはこちらの梅の花。梅。
So first we're going to make this plum flower.
まずできたアワビ。
So take a knot which is already done.
本数が多い方が可愛いと思います。
すいません、もう一度お願いします。本数？
本数、この本数ですね。1、2、3の本数。
はい。So, if you have more strands, it's more beautiful and more cute.
左のこちらの3本。左から出た3本をこの真ん中に入れていきます。
So you'll take the three strands on the left and then put it into the middle.
上から真ん中の穴に入れます。
So take it from the top and then put it into the middle hole.
このお花は5枚の花びらがあるので、1、2、3、4となります。
So here, since there are 5 petals, the ones around will be 1, 2 and 3, 4 petals.
なので、少し丸く残したぐらいで、引きすぎないように、花びらを作って置いておきます。
So like this, make sure you don't pull it completely. Pull a bit and let's form petals.
右の水引きは今できた花びらに上から入ります。
So you will take the right strand and it will be put into the petal that you just made.
並び、水引きの並びを整えながら。
So as you adjust the 水引き、
この真ん中の方に出た余りの部分と今入れた余りの部分、同じ方向にお互いに引っ張っていくと。
So then, the leftover strands, you will pull lightly. すみません、先生、質問があります。
はい、
ここでなんか、wool、なんか、wool、別の、水引きの代わりに、別の木材、羊毛も使うことができますか？
針があれば大丈夫だと思うので、モールとか、モールとか、
はい、ウール、
モール、
ウール、
わかる？モール、針金が入った、
毛糸はいいですかって、
うん、針金の入ったような毛糸だったら大丈夫と思いますし、コルクボードに針を刺しながらこの手順をやっていただくと毛糸でも可能です。できます。
So if you have a glue, then you can use wool with glue, and then you can make the 水引き。
Add a glue to the wool?
Yeah. So like I think there's this glueish kind of wool that you get. So with that, I think you can make.
はい、ありがとうございます。
はい。これで梅の花の出来上がりです。
So now with this we have made the plum flower.
後ろでこの上に来てるクロスの後ろでクロスにして
So take the strand from below.
この間にグルーを入れていきます。
So in the middle, we will put the glue.
このように押さえて、グルーが乾くまでピンチで押さえておきます。
So if you have something to hold the 水引き, you will place that until the glue dries.
かわいたら、こんな感じに。
So once it dries, it looks like this.
った部分を表から見えないようにカットして。
And then you cut the strands so that it's not seen in front.
これで出来上がりです。
And it's done. You have your plum flower.
本数を増やしていくと、この隙間がない梅の花ができます。
If you use more strands, then you will have this kind of a plum flower where there are no holes. You won't be able to see the hole.
好きな感じでトライしてみてください。
So, try this plum flower as you like. Try different variations of it.
次に日本で作ったアワビ結び。
Next, we will use、the アワビ結び which use two strands.
こちらの輪っかを作っていきたいと思います。
And we're going to create these rings.あの先生すみません質問があります。
はい。
あのこのあのそのワイヤーよりなんか今の水引きよりあのワイヤーとか使ってもよろしいでしょうか。2つのワイヤー。
グルーじゃなくてってことですか。
そうですね。なんかあの今紐よりなんかワイヤーが使える。
I think Scooby wires,、people are using Scooby wires, so they're finding it a little bit difficult.、I think、what、Soham San is saying, can you demonstrate with two wires so that they can、use the Scooby,、two Scooby wires to、try and make the designs?
Okay, 今皆さんが使ってるその紐はちょっと硬いみたいなので、Scooby wire というものちょっと硬いみたいなので、また2つのワイヤーでもう一度Do they want to know how to make the Awa Musubi again? Is that the thing? Ranita-san?
I think the plum flower they're talking about.
Plum flower. もう一度、その梅の花を2つの紐でもう一度見せていただいてもよろしいでしょうか？
はい、大丈夫です。じゃあ、この2本のアワビ。アワビからやりましょうか。
So shall we make, we'll make from again the base using the two strands. Shall we do it from the base or is it just the flower?
I think just the flower.
Just the flower?
Yes.
はい、ただの梅の花だけで大丈夫です。
はい。そうしましたらこちらのアワビ。中心を下にして。
So the middle will come below.
手があまりが上向くように。
So the leftover strands have to face upwards.
左にあるあまりの水引きをアワビ結びの。
So the left strand.
この穴、ここですね。この真ん中の四角い穴。ここに上から入れるだけ。
So you take the left strand and you put it in the middle. The middle shape is kind of like a square. So you put it into the middle of the square. From the top.
花びらを作るように引いていって。
So pull it in such a way that you form a petal.
右の紐は今できた輪っか、ここに上から入る。
Then the、right strand will go into the、first petal that you have made from the top.
入れっぱなしではなく、こちら下に出たあまりの部分の方に横にあるあまりも持ってきてお互いに引っ張ってあげるとお互いが支えて梅の花が出来上がります。
So you take the two strands and adjust them so they are coming in the same direction. Then slowly pull them and then you will get the flower petal.
表側の反対を向けると形がかわいい梅ができるのですが。
So if you flip it, you will get a cute、plum flower.
この上にできたバッテン、クロスの後ろで余りの部分もクロスします。
So in the top there was a kind of a cross. So from the back you will make sure to cross the two strands in the same way.
で、この押さえてある部分、ここにグルーを塗って乾かします。
So then, once you cross the strands at the back, you will put glue on it and allow it to dry.
たっぷり。
Make sure to add lots of glue. And then you will hold it down until it dries. Use something to hold it down till it dries. Is it all right? Any other questions?
Just one like this.
Hi. ではもう一つですね。
We'll take another.
はい、輪っかを作っていきます。
So we're going to make rings now.
あわび結び。少し外側の輪っかを外に引っ張って輪っか大きくしていきます。
So what you do is the awamusubi that you made, pull the right and left rings, pull it till you make the hole bigger, the ring bigger.
下にできたバッテンは、クロスは少し中心にぐっと寄せときます。
So what you do, when you pull both sides, there'll be a cross that will come. So you'll pull it such that it comes towards the middle.
ここに2つの山がある。
So it looks like there are two mountains here.
左から来てる上の、この上の山を右手で持って、
Take the left ring, which is on top, with your right hand.
下にある右から来てる輪っかを左手で持ってぐーっと右は右、左は左で引っ張ります。
Then
はい。
Then take the other ring, with your left hand and then push it up.And so it's like the left ring with the left hand, right ring with the right hand, and then you will pull it in this way.
ここの中心のクロスした部分を押さえて、
So hold the cross part.
右にある水引きで、こちらの水引き、こちらの紐を拾っていきます。
So you'll take the 水引き in the right hand and you're going to expand the hole there.
上から入って拾ってあげる。
So then you put the strand again through the hole and then you pull.
で、この時にしっかりこう出さずに少し拾って、ちょっと出たところで、今度は左にあるこちらの紐を押さえて、輪に上から入って出ます。
So what you do is when you pull the strand, you don't pull it out completely. You take it out just a bit, and then you put it into the left hole, and then you pull it out. So you'll get this shape.
本の紐がずっと絡み合って輪になることから縁結び、結婚したい時のお守りとか、そういった感じで使われる結びです。
Since these two strands keep intermingling and intertwined like this, it is known as en musubi, which means something for good luck, and it's used for weddings to bring good luck to people.
で、ここではまだ輪っかがつながってないので、左にある水引きの後ろに右の水引きを入れてあげます。
So since the last string is not yet made, so you take the right string and then put it below the left string.
こうすることで、こうずっと永遠にぐるぐる。
So like this, it's like, you know, it keeps spinning for eternity.
とってもかわいい結びなので、ぜひ覚えてください。
Since it's a very cute knot, please do remember it.
こちらも水引き、重なった水引きと水引きのこの余りの部分のところにグルーを入れておいて。
So you'll put glue in the leftover, between the leftover parts of the string.
乾いてから切ると。
So once it's dry, then you will cut it.
かわいい輪っかが出来上がります。
And with this, you have a cute, ring.
こんな感じで結んでいきます。
So like this, we'll keep on making the knots.
そしたら今度はポチ袋に、袋に飾りをつけていきたいと思います。
So like this, you will put it into a box. すいません。ちょっと質問がありますが、先ほどのループをどうやって締めましたんですか？クリップとか使いましたんですか？先ほどの輪っかの、同じようにクリップで、
そうです。
すみません。はい。Yes, so they use a clip to close the ring.
はい。そうしましたら、最後になりますが、袋につけていきたいと思います。
Now, this will be the last bit. We're going to now stick this onto a bag.
先ほどお見せしたこういったものは伝統的なものになります。
So as we showed this earlier, this is a very traditional 水引き。
今、カジュアルなものもたくさんできています。
So、we also have casual ones.
こういったアワビ結びの中に花を入れたり、
So you can put flower like that in the middle.
とても小さい袋だったり。
Or you can put it in small bags.
こちらは貼っちゃってます。グルーで水引きのアイテムを貼っちゃってます。
So like this, we have stuck the mizuhiki that we have made.
こんな感じにカジュアルにお手紙に添えていってもいいかと思います。
So it'll be very nice and cute if you stick all of these onto the letters.
こちらの梅を袋につけたいと思います。つけ方は、
So now I'm going to stick this onto this bag.
つけ方は、もう一本紐を用意して。
So in order to stick it, you take another strand.
水引きの中心あたりを。
Once again, you hold the middle of the string.
袋の後ろに持っていって。
Take it behind the envelope.
表にして。
And then bring it to the front. Bring the strands to the front.
靴紐を結ぶように。
And then tie it like you tie your shoelaces.
普通に結びます。
So like this, you'll just tie the string.
ここはぎゅーっと結んじゃってください。
So make sure you pull the knot tightly. Tie the knot tightly.
結び目から出た余りのこの紐を
Take the leftover strands.
梅の真ん中からこう後ろから通して
So pull it out through the back in, and in through the middle of the plum flower
引っ張っていきます
And you will pull it
梅の花からちょっと結び目が出る感じまで引っ張って
So until you can see a kind of knot that is formed here, keep pulling.
これであ
、先生すみません、ちょっと質問があります。はい、先生はどのような針を使っていますか？
針。
はい。すみません、糊。どの針を使っていますか？
木工用ボンド、木の、
はい、
工作に使う木工用ボンド。
So she uses a kind of bond, like which we use even for wood.
あとはホットボンドとかでもすごく水引き相性がいいです。
So you can also use a hot bun.
グルーガンってやつですかね。こう、はい、ピストルの形した。
はい。
で、こちら、あんまり短いと抜けてしまうんですが、この梅よりも出たところで切ってもらうと、
So if you cut it too short, it will come out. So make sure that the strands come out a bit on both sides of the flower.
これで出来上がりなんですが、こちら、あわび結び。
So with this, it is done. And now we make the あわび結び。
アワビ結びも同じようにつけられます。
And you can even tie the アワビ結び in the same way.
ぜひ録画して何度も見ていろいろたくさん作ってみてください。
So make sure you know you watch videos and then keep trying.Make them, 水引き。
そろそろお時間なのでお疲れ様でした。
So thank you all for watching up till now. So with this we will end the workshop. おい先生から。
はい。
あの、おい先生に一言。
三ツ俣先生、今日はどうもありがとうございました。
Thank you so much.
ありがとうございます。はい。皆さん、上手に水引きできましたでしょうか？
Were you all able to make beautiful 水引き today?
インドの封筒に貼ってみても可愛いかもしれませんね。
So it'll be nice to have this on your envelopes, right?
ジャパンブリッジチームのコーディネーターは、ヤシャシュリーさんとソハムさん。
So the Japan Bridge coordinators, Yashashri san and Soham san.
チャットコーディネーターはラニタさん。
The chat coordinator was Ranita san.
そして通訳はアクシャラさん。
The interpreter was me, Akshara.
そして私はオエでした。最後までお付き合いいただきありがとうございました。
And she is Miss Oe. So thank you so much for being with us till now. Thank you so much.
引き続き、はい、ジャパンハッパ楽しんでください。京子さん、ありがとうございました。
はい、ありがとうございました。
So please enjoy the Japan Habba. And thank you so much, Miss Mitsumata さん。
ありがとうございました。
ありがとう。
Thank you, one and all.
Over to the MCs now. Thank you.
Okay, you're off here. Thank you.
Greetings, Mizuhiki participants. A second reminder regarding the surprise Mizuhiki contest. First, in order to enter, take a picture of your best Mizuhiki knot you learned today and create it. Now, the entry details. Upload your best picture on your Facebook or Instagram account with the hashtag Japan Habba Mizuhiki. I repeat, upload your best picture on your Facebook or Instagram account with the hashtag Japan Habba Mizuhiki. Send the post to the Japan Habba Instagram account or to Japan Habba Bangalore on Facebook. Mitsumata Sama will personally select the two best entries from the contest.The winners will receive a gift voucher worth ₹2,500 from Amazon.com. May the best entry win. Thank you.